Man, isn't that just the coolest outfit? There's just something about it I absolutely love. I don't know, call me crazy. Anyway, this video is chock full of fun things. This is just some of my baking stuff, but here we go. So I have been in this little store in front of me for the last, let me start my car and see what time it is. For the last 15 minutes, he's been working with me to make a copy of something for me, okay? It's for Giovanni's school. This needs to be enlarged so Giovanni can see it. One rectangle. Okay, it's pretty simple. One on each page and enlarge it where Giovanni can see it because they're gonna put it on like poster board. Okay, so he looked at the page and he said, it's too faded. I said, well, I took photos. I have it on my phone. Can I send it to you? It took a while for us to figure out how to get it sent because it wouldn't go to the number, but then it went to his email. From the email, he printed it. Easy enough, right? But he said, it looks like it's a snapshot of a video. I said, it is. That's what she has on her paper. That's what I did too. So he goes back and I said, it's okay if it doesn't look perfect. He printed it. It's great. Guess how much it cost me? 2 quetzales. Okay, 2 quetzales divided by 7.75. It's like 30 cents was all I had to pay for his 15 minutes of work to print this for me. I'm flabbergasted. I don't know. For some reason, I can't believe how cheap that was. Is it that cheap everywhere? Because I think, man, he had to, you know, do the work and 30 cents? Really? Craziness. Anyway, I'm off to deliver these to the school now. Bye, Mommy. Okay, here's Mia and I on our daily walk. There's Madre's land over there. Just a sneak peek at her little land, her land. She's got tons. The convent. Wow. There's the land that they've been hand farming, getting ready with corn and beans. But he said corn over here, so. Yeah, kids are in school and I don't have any big plans for the day. No, I don't. No big plans. The men are working on the driveway. The ladies are cleaning the house, doing laundry. And it's very calm and peaceful. And Mia and I are enjoying ourselves. So the girls needed school supplies. The girls needed school supplies. They needed felt, like 4 different colors. Stop. Start the car. Start the car. 4 different colors of felt. He starts the car. Oh, there go the windshield wipers. Come on, Giovanni, start it. It's hot down here. We're in a parqueo down under the ground, downstairs. It's concrete, and it's a little bit better. And it's closer to the cloth store, because not only did they need felt, they needed a picture of Mom, and they needed, like, ribbon to trim it out. Can you unroll your window, Giovanni, please? So I had to go to 3 stores. The first store had a parking lot very tiny in front of it, so I could get them to print the pictures, which remember I already went there today for Giovanni. Then the next store was a libreria, which is like a bookstore, and they only had the felt, they didn't have the other stuff. So I parked in front and turned my flashers on. You see all these posts? This makes it kind of hard. I'm looking at my camera and backing, see? All the posts down here. Okay, so anyway, I went to the libreria and got that stuff, and they said, we don't have this, whatever they call ribbon, I forget. And I said, talzone or something like that. And I said, oh, where do I go for that? We have to go to the cloth store. Well, the cloth store is at the Mercado. There's no way you can park illegally and put your hazards on there. So I had to park in the parqueo, which only cost me 2Q, which was like 30 cents, which is worth it. And now we're leaving out of here. Gracias. So we're leaving this space. This is kind of where we are. Coming out onto the street, and we gotta get back home to get the stuff and to the girls, get them in their backpacks, do Giovanni's homework, and the ladies leave at 4, and it's already 3:10, and it'll take me almost that long to get out of here and back up the hill. And really where I need to go is right there, but I have to go all the way around the Mercado in order to get there. So that's what I'm doing. Coming out. Ooh. If I can do this without hitting the curb.
When I got home, Mercedes called. Remember, Mercedes is the gal that took care of our family for an entire year when we first came to Guatemala. And she's playing hide and go seek via FaceTime with Amelia. Amelia's counting in Spanish. She had so much fun.
She got you. Uh-huh, Mercedes.
Uno, dos.
That's the way it works. Are we going to school?
Yeah.
Yes, who's going to have the
best day ever?
Best day ever, yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, my goodness. Where's Gianna?
Gianna.
Gianna. There she comes. Come on, it's about time to go. Make sure your lunch is in your backpack. There she comes. There she is. Hello, hello. Okay, let's get our lunches and our backpacks and everything to the door. I'm still having my hot tea, so. Whose lunch is up there? Is that yours, baby cakes? Okay. Because I can't. La 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 la. That stove over there, we're redoing this kitchen here, and we're doing the kitchen upstairs. This is a mess, isn't it? Anyway, so this stove is going in one of them. I don't know which one. And yeah, so it's hanging out. It's hanging out on the wall. Nice, Giovanni, nice. Okay, by the front door, baby, after you get them in your backpack. Amelia, come on, let's go. We gotta get to school. It's 6:40. This truck is loaded and nothing is tied down. Nothing. Nothing is secured. How is he keeping it on there? He made his rounds to all the convenience stores and then last stop was back to the grocery store. I imagine to try to sell everything that was left. Is he gonna go to the grocery store? So before the girls go to school, we usually have close to an hour to spend after we drop off Giovanni. And we usually head to the grocery store and just pick up a few odds and ends.
Let me see what other flavors they have. Here's orange and, oh, that'd be good. Orange and ginger and curcumin. That's good. Okay, now I just need black. I don't need it with a flavor.
I just need it. Then we decided to check out what games they had available in the grocery store. The selection wasn't very good, but we're starting to play games at home, kind of to learn not to fight, not to cheat, and have a good, fun time. Oh, brother, what have I gotten myself into? They want everything they see. And the problem is, most of these toys are just junk. They'll fall apart after we play with them one time. Let's wait till we go to a real toy store.
Scrabble, you build words. We'll think about it. No, that one's just a, we'll think about it. What is this one? Stack, you just stack things up. We'll look in the libreria. They'll probably have more games, okay? Okay, I'm not buying a puppy game right now. Okay, let's go. Get Giovanni little M&Ms. Do you see
Now they did get to pick out some candy for after school, and then they always look to see which register is open, and some of the people here know them by name. They kind of like the grocery store in the morning. Not only check out the craziness at the stoplight with the traffic, but look at the man juggling knives. He's doing it for money. This happens all the time here in Guatemala. He's pretty daggum good. And at the next corner, we counted homeless dogs. Sometimes we see up to 15 just on one sidewalk.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
And then we stopped to buy tortillas, and the girls wanted to get out of the car. Now the man on the motorcycle there was waiting for quite a few, so the girls had to wait their turn. And they just don't quite understand waiting their turn. They're kind of impatient. But they did a good job. They ordered them, they gave them their money, and they waited patiently. Still waiting, still waiting. Boy, did they want those tortillas. The wait is almost over, and I'll tell you what, there's other places they could get their tortillas around here, obviously, but they love to come visit these ladies every morning. You can't beat those smiles, nor the hot, fresh tortillas. Gianna can eat 3 before school. Amelia, usually a half of one. The lady on the right is opening her storefront for business, and the man just ahead of her, right there, is pushing a wheelbarrow full of wood down the street. And check it out, this is a two-way street. Where the heck am I supposed to drive? You have to be patient, and usually nobody even honks. He's got an entire house in the back of that pickup. He's probably a moving company. And here comes another car headed my way on my side of the road, and more ladies making tortillas. And here we are heading into the mercado. It was busy. This is Thursday morning, and they're bringing in all the fresh produce. Check out these pictures. Now remember, this is only about 8 o'clock in the morning on Thursday. The girls haven't even gotten to school yet. Okay, now the girls are in school and I am up at San Andreas, pretty close to the house.
Okay, so I needed a cake, and I decided to go inside there, and they are very somber inside. Not the friendliest. This is San Andreas Amitabá, and I don't come here usually. This is their town square. That's the old Catholic church over there, and the new one is up on the hill behind this bakery that I just went in. This is kind of their main street, and they've already got their music going this morning. So I am heading back to the house. I don't come here by myself very often because it's very authentic here and I feel very obvious. So let's back up and get out of here and I'll show you kind of kind of what I mean. Look, there's the front of the church. Isn't that beautiful? It's an old church. It got, I think it got destroyed at one time by an earthquake, but if I understand correctly, they are using it some, so let's see. It is beautiful. Well, here we go, Mia. She wants to walk. I really don't. I think it's going to rain. It's 9 in the morning. And she's ready. Can't even see up there. We're in a cloud, Mia. We're in a cloud, baby. Okay, here we go. Okay, a quick video of my plants. Mia actually got up here the other day. Inside the box and here on this edge, the outside edge, which is a good drop, and she dug and tore up my plants. So this one was really full and she ate it, but I mean she trimmed it up pretty good. She didn't bother the roses because they're full of thorns, so she didn't bother this one. This one she tore up pretty good, this one she really tore up, and this one. But let me tell you something, it rained here last night. And I took all of the main twigs like this that she tore off of my plants and stuck them in the dirt. And they're growing. I mean, I'm from Amarillo, Texas. And you stick something in the dirt and nothing will happen. But these are growing. This one, she had jumped in the middle, dug it all up. And today it's full again. It came back to life. In Amarillo, it would have died. Look at this. I mean, some of these may not make it, but some of them may root and take off. And that's the way they do it here, is you just get the twig, put it in the dirt, and the rain comes, and it grows again. Like, this one was so big and pretty, and she just tore it up. So I put the little pieces and parts around. I hope they catch, but this was so beautiful. This one's still crying. Anyway. And I picked up a couple plants along my walk today. I picked up this one right here. And this one right here, a little fern. And they will grow. It's amazing how fast things grow. With good soil and the rain and the sun. The sun is intense up here. So, not today, obviously. But my poor flowers went through hell. I might have to buy a couple new ones. Doesn't that give me reason? Anyway, there we go. It's a beautiful day and we finished our walk. And if you've been watching the videos, you know that the men down below are putting in a driveway. They took out the grass, they leveled it, they built a retaining wall, and now they are putting in a full driveway with these blocks. By hand, two men doing an excellent job. Giovanni's teacher sent me this video of him right there participating in phys ed class. Isn't it great? And then, yes, that is a man standing in the middle of the road up there. He does look small because he is very short stature, but he has a machete. Do you see that? He's just standing there, and that's perfectly normal here. Here come the bike riders going up towards the man in the road. All is normal in Guatemala. All is normal. And of course we have the daily parachuters. I just love them.
I can hear them talking. I can hear the wind in the sail. It's awesome. And then I heard a puppy cry behind my house. These are the neighbor's stairs through a locked gate. These two dogs came through the field and entered the property and were kind of lost. And
4:30 in the afternoon and it's raining. Isn't this beautiful? It's cool, kind of brisk up here, a little bit of a breeze. Look at this. And it just comes straight down. See that? Look at that. This is beautiful. I know it's probably not amazing to a lot of people, but when you come from Amarillo, Texas, rain that comes straight down without tornadoes and huge hail and thunderstorms is amazing. It's just unbelievable. Like, where's the lightning and the thunder and the craziness? They're still working down below. It's almost done. They just got to trim it out. That's all. It's all done. It's just got sand on top because they use sand to fill in the crevices in between. How do you say that? I don't know. Where the blocks meet. But look how green it is already. That was all brown just last week. It's just the rain is tremendous, isn't it? It was like that patch right there all over last week. This is beautiful and I had to share it. Wow. Welcome, rainy season. Welcome. And now it is, let's see, now it's almost 6:30. I can hear people hooping and hollering in the town below. Look at those volcanoes, aren't they beautiful? And more rain coming, look at that. Oh, it's so heavy. I can just see it. So I just washed that off. There's the pila. The stairs, they look so much better than they did when we moved in. Got a wall built there. Right there is a stone wall that they built, like a retention wall. And then tomorrow they'll trim out around all the stairs and the edges. But this right here is what it's gonna look like. That is all done. This is a concrete, like a trough, for draining the rainwater. All of this is already done. It's got sand on top of it. So all of this will be play space for the kids and the puppy. It's gonna be so nice. Nice and clean, nice and clean. Well, I think that's about a wrap for this video. There's my little Gianna. She's looking all cute with her little hat and her purse. Wanted her picture taken, so you bet I took it. You guys, here's a few memories, a blast from the past. Our first trip to Guatemala with the kids. One in a wheelchair and two in a stroller. And back in Amarillo, they had a triple stroller. Eating with Dad, Aunt Allie with Dad and the kids. Oh my goodness, look at that. Isn't that precious? Christmas pictures. That was getting ready for Santa, and here they are. What do they like better, candy or Dad? I just don't know. Say a prayer for me, friends. I'll say a prayer for you, and I'll see you on the next video. Goodbye, everybody.